And people, here's more proof, right, that while the United States Marshal Service thought that it was playing me and setting me up and befriending me, that the entire universe was conspiring against them also. I might be naive, people. I could admit that I was naive, but my avatar wasn't. My Lord wasn't naive. So people, as y'all can recall, right, I sued Fremont Investment and Loan because they were the one who originated the mortgage, okay? And they're in Brea, California. So people, and in August, let me see, August 24, 2007, I filed a lawsuit when the judge in the district court allowed me to file my lawsuit. So on August 24, 2007, I took to U.S. Marshal Service summons, right, to serve to Fremont in California. It was received by, it was filed to Santa Ana, right? And September 5th, 2007, it was received by Santa Ana September 10th, 2007. But people, hear how the trick is coming now, right? If this was received by Santa Ana on September 10th, how come it was not served to Fremont until, where's the date? Until September 19, 2007. 9 days, people, after it was received. That's not the U.S. Marshal Service, people. They usually serve you quick. Okay? So for them to say that this was served 9 days later caused alarm bells to ring. But people, that's not the point. The point being, people, right? I was waiting for them to give me proof that Fremont was served because we had a court day coming. The court day was August 29th, I think, August 27th. So Fremont had to receive this complaint at least 20 days before August 27th. Maybe it's not the right day I'm saying, but anyway, they had to receive 20 days before the court date. Right? So they could respond. So people, if Fremont received it on September 19th, right, that mean by September 29th, they will still be in play, right, by September 29th. So the actual date of the hearing was September 27th, right? So September 27th. So what they did, people, was they received their service 2 days before the deadline. But people, I was waiting for the service and I never got it. So I called the U.S. Marshal Service now and they told me to come and get a copy. So people, I went downtown to the courthouse, but I bypassed the U.S. Marshal Service, and I don't know why, but I bypassed them. I went up to the clerk's office, to the judge's clerk's office, and asked for a copy. And they gave me this, people. They gave me this copy right here. But people, and I'm going to go ahead and explain to you why. I didn't get this. I got this from the U.S. Marshal in the mail 2 days later. But I got this page right here, which is, no, see people, this wasn't for me, people. This is to the clerk. See, people, see? Look, number one, to the clerk. That's proof right there, people. This is proof. I got this from the clerk's office. See, say, to clerk. So I'm going to show you our minds now. This is my copy right here. My copy is number 3, notice of service. So this is what I'm supposed to get. Okay, this is what I'm supposed to get. It's supposed to be a duplicate of what, it's supposed to be a duplicate of what the clerk got. Clerk copy, my copy. However, people, there's something that the clerk gave me that the U.S. Marshal Service never gave me. The clerk gave me a sworn affidavit. Now, if you look at this sworn affidavit, people, okay? Return of service, okay? Service of the summons and complaint was made by me. Date 9. Look at that. People, does it look like a 919 to you? Does it look like 919 to you? You don't, right? It look like somebody tried to put off a kind of, right, people? People, don't that look like 9? Okay, hold up. What does it look like, people? Okay, 9, whatever, 2007. Okay? And he said, name of server. I'm not going to call it, see his name, name of server. Deputy U.S. Marshal. Okay? Now, he said right here, left copy of the defendant's dwelling. Okay. He served it. Actually, he was serving hand. Okay. And he said here, right? And the people, this is a sworn affidavit. Okay. Declaration of server. Declaration of server. Okay. He's saying that I declare under penalty of perjury under the law, laws of the United States of America, that the foregoing information contained in the return of service and statement of service fees is true and correct. And what date did he do this, people? Look at the date. Look, people, look at the date. Look at the date, people. Look at the date. Don't I say 9/11/2007, people? Executed on September 11, 2007. Sworn under pain under penalty of perjury. September 11th. Okay, now you can see right here that someone attempt to make a hook. Look at that, people. That's September 11th he wrote there. Someone attempt to make a hook. Okay, over here now, we had, look at that. Hold up, wait a minute. You see that? You said the 19th. But people, we know this is bogus. Because because the date, right? If Fremont was served on September 11th, do you know what that would mean? That would mean they were in default. Okay? That would mean they were in, because they were in default, people know for a fact. Because I served Fremont myself by fax. Because the judge told me to serve them any way possible I can. And I served them by the marshal and served them by fax. I even spoke to the attorneys, to the legal department. So they were served. But when I tried to tell the judge people, and guess what? I wrote an affidavit to the judge people to tell the judge that I had something to tell him and he need to keep it from Fremont attorney. And people, the judge told me to do a motion and he was going to impound it. And people, I said, I did a motion. Do you know that they gave it to the attorneys? I didn't want the U.S. Marshal to know that I would answer what they did. Because people, this is straight up fraud. This is impropriety that Fremont was in default, but someone committed fraud and said they were served on the 19th so that they won't be default on the 27th when we have an affidavit here say he was served on 9/11. This is sworn. This is not. Okay? This is fraud, people. This is United States Marine Service and the federal court committing fraud on behalf of the United States Department of Justice. United States Marshal Service committing fraud on behalf of the banksters. Okay, people, here's the proof. Okay, here's the proof. That's that Paul Mucker. And if you go to the court, you will see the same documents, the same thing. So Paul Mucker didn't create this. This is fraud. So Matthew Dumas and John, what his name, John, and John, for you all setting me up and singing Old Pirate, Yes, Rabbi with me, for you all setting me up I open my heart to you guys. I open my heart to you. I thought you were my friend, but my Lord wasn't sleeping. And you all came in my house and you all sat with me. And you all shook hands with me like brothers. And I even erased, I had a video of you all and I erased it. I erased the video I had evidence against you guys. And you know it. And I erased it and you guys were so happy. You guys shook my hand when I erased a video I made of you. Okay? I made a video of you guys. I had your face in the video. And I showed you the video that I erased it. I showed it to you. I told you I wasn't going to use it against you. And that was the icebreaker. People, I made a video of these guys, people. I made a video of them. Of your faces and stuff, right? And to show them that I mean them no harm. And to show them that I wanted to be their friends. I showed them. I erased the video in front of their face. And they look at each other. They couldn't believe it, people. And I really thought that I showed them that I was being honest with them. And people took advantage of my honesty. People, I told them, I said to them, even about the stuff they stole from me, people, I told them about it. I said, listen, guys, I know you know what I do. I'm not no dummy, you're watching me. But honesty is my best policy. Honesty is supposed to save me, it's supposed to set me free. I said, you have nowhere to put people in jail for this, you know that. It was created by God, not by you or man. And when you put a jury, you tell a jury to swear in the Bible to uphold truth. But in Genesis, it says, God made the earth of the field for all men. So can you arrest me for this? I said, I will beat you with the Constitution if you try to arrest me for this. So I was honest with them, people. I was so honest with them. Because my God told me, be honest, Paul. Be honest, because it's going to save you. And he was right, because people, instead of busting me, they stole it from me. So my Lord told me, be honest with them. Tell them what you have. Throw it to the robbers. Throw 30 pieces of silver to the robbers. Okay? $30,000 worth. Wow. Is that a coincidence, people? $30,000. He said, throw it to them. Throw it to them. Throw it to the robbers. That principal price that they set on me. Okay, people? So, my Lord told me to be honest. Because he said they locked me up for it. I used the Constitution against them. Because they have no right to say what God made is illegal. They have no right to do that. They are natural laws. Natural laws supersede man-made laws. And the federal courts knows this. They know it. So anyway, the point being, people, I was honest with these people. I was so honest with them. Because my Lord told me, Paul, be honest. They are, Paul, you have guns in your house? No, I have no guns in my house. Because that's not me. I'm not violent. Because when I have a gun in my house, he's going to cause me to pick it up. When I get angry. So why should I tempt myself? So I throw those things away. And I use my fist. That's my gun. So I was honest with these people. I don't have no guns in my house. I don't have no bombs in my house. I'm not planning any violence unless I'm forced to. And I opened my heart to them, people. I opened my soul to them. And they took advantage of me. Okay? And I was going to give them this information. People, I swear to you. I even told them, I said, I have a gift for you. Because people, I thought, I wanted to expose this long time ago, but I was scared. So when the people came down now and befriend me, I was going to give them all this paperwork just to show them, yo, man, here's another peace offering. I was going to expose your marine friend, but because you're so nice to me, I'm going to throw it away. I swear to you, people, and my life, I was going to give them this. I was going to give it to them just to show them another peace offering. Just like I erased that video that I have of them, it's the same way. I was going to give them this information just to throw it out, so I won't be tempted to use it. Because I wanted peace, people. I gave them a peace offering. And they rejected it. Okay? The chastisement of your peace was on me. I offered you peace and you rejected it. No, I don't want no peace, no. I don't want equal rights. I want justice. Then we'll talk about equal rights. Okay? I want justice. Then we'll talk about equal rights. United States Department of Justice. It's not justice. It's just them. There's over 6 billion laws on earth, but there ain't no justice. 6 billion human beings, over. All of them are law unto themselves, but they not want justice. Wow. And you all call me a criminal? And you all put me in prison? Man, you all should be put in dungeon.
Bob shot the sheriff. But it was Marco who shoot the deputy. Bob shot the sheriff, but it was Marco who shoot the deputy. Sheriff John Brown already hated me. For what? I don't know. It was Bob who shot the sheriff. But Muggle shot the deputy. It was Bob who shot the sheriff. But Muggle shot the deputy.
One love, one heart, one destiny for all the children of the life and humanity.